Hello, hey dear YouTubers, this is Tina, and today I'm discussing HBX with you. So, you wanna take HBX, and you considering, shall I spend 2000 bucks on that, or is there a better application for this money? So, here are gonna be the five things that you should ask yourself and answer them before taking HBX, and hopefully those five things are gonna help you determine if you wanna take the course or you might as do something else. So, the thing number one, go to check.com and find the sample questions. I'm not gonna tell you how. If you found this video, you're, I believe, a smart person, you'll find how to find the questions on check.com from HBX Core. Find the sample questions, especially try to find a sample questions from business analytics, because as in the video where I talked about bad stuff from HBX Core, I said that I felt like business analytics modules, most of them was just like a bunch of randomly selected words in like abracadabra Chinese language. So really go to check, find sample questions, and these are the kind of questions and material and information you'll be learning throughout the course. Look at them, really spend like some time finding, reading through those questions, and this will give you a very good understanding of what kind of material you will expect to encounter with on there for the next 3 months. Thing number two, ask yourself, do you like to write? Do you like to write? Because you would have to provide suggested guesses, because in many cases, no, absolutely everywhere actually, you would have to write and answer open-ended questions, propose solutions to certain problems that are presented to you, or you would have to summarize what you have just learned. Basically a lot of writing, and I personally absolutely hated it, because usually, and I just feel more comfortable learning in this manner, like just watching videos and answering test questions and quizzes, maybe writing some review in the end of the module, but not doing it like every 10 minutes or sometimes even more often, especially during the end of the, in the last modules, I feel like there was more writing required from you. So I really didn't enjoy that part. So ask yourself, do you have time and would you feel comfortable with writing a lot? Writing, what I mean by writing, there's going to be a question on there for you, where the question can be like, please identify how you think the company shall find what is their consumer surplus. What would you propose to figure out what's the consumer surplus of this and that company? Or a question can be, we just discussed a new term, identify three key things that you think unnecessary, la la la. Or even sometimes it would be, there would be a question and before seeing the answer, you ask to propose your answer, and only after that you'll be able to read the actual answer to the question. So a lot of writing. Ask yourself, do you like to write? Would you have energy for that? Because obviously when you're writing, you need to like focus and concentrate more. Thing number three, are you doing it for yourself? Are you spending money, this $2,000, so how much is the course now? Maybe a little more. Is this a lot of money for you? Or is it a company paying this money for you? Because listen, if $2,000 is really like a very big sacrifice for you, and you're even like considering to take a loan for that, just really no fucking way, don't take it. If $2,000 is really a lot of money for you, please, please, please don't take it. There's, you know, great website like Udemy. You can learn from books, audiobooks, Udemy, even hire a private tutor for this money. That's really a lot of money. So ask yourself, are you doing it because it's just Harvard, because it sounds cool, because you feel like you're special now because you're taking a course from Harvard? I'm sorry, but nowadays nobody cares about which school you went to or how many books you read. That nobody cares about this in today's world. Today it's all about, tell me what you know, tell me what you can do, tell me maybe who you know, but just having a name on your LinkedIn profile, hey, I have taken the Harvard online, okay, online, not even real. Maybe if you went to real Harvard, it would be like, still considered like, yeah, pretty cool, but it's just online Harvard course. And if you're taking just for the name, please don't do it. Really, please don't do it. It's stupid. Like on Udemy, you can find courses with the same information, same material for $2,000. And just subscribe to HBX Review magazine and read it twice, 2 hours a day. You're gonna get the same amount of information. So ask yourself, why are you doing that? Number four, are you based in the United States? Do you have customers in the US? Do you have business in the United States? Are you planning to move your business in the United States? Because if you don't, then really a lot of this material, especially accounting and certain concepts of economics, economics and managers, are not relevant to their other countries, the world outside the United States. So I would really not recommend you taking this course if you have nothing to do with US and selling to the US and understanding how business is here. That might even confuse you really, because I'm sorry, but business is not being done in Russia the way it is being presented in this course in economics and managers, unfortunately, but it is reality, it is true. Yeah, I'm repeating this again and again. If you're not based in US, you have nothing to do with US and United States customers, you really don't need this course. It's not a good idea, not a good choice. Thing number five, I already mentioned it. Ask yourself why I was doing it, because it was a part of my requirement. Ask yourself, why are you doing that? Is there, try to look for other solutions compared to other existing courses on the same material, and try maybe Udemy. There's lots of, how many courses you can buy for $15 on a budget of $2,000. You can even hire, in addition to those concepts that you're really interested, a private tutor for you. There was tip number five, how should I summarize it? Consider Udemy instead. That's how I summarize it. So these were my five questions that you should ask yourself, and like be honest with yourself and answer them before committing to this 3 months of brainstorming and time being spent in trying with their laptop away from your friends and the outside world. That was Tina. Please post questions. I'll answer all of them. Good luck on your HBX exam if you're already taking this this course. Keep continue learning. You know, as long as you're trying and doing and learning something new, it's still better than nothing. Bye bye, everyone.